Hello, welcome. It's Monday and it is my next video. I'm really, really excited because I'm actually being interviewed by my youngest son, Clark. Now, I am going to introduce him. I'm going to tell you a little bit about Clark. So Clark is the youngest of our three sons. Louis is the oldest. He lives in Australia. Jack is the middle one. He lives in Costa Rica. And Clark was the perfect boy. Okay, he was. Growing up, he was perfect in every way, really. He was absolutely so well behaved, absolutely fantastic. We only had one indiscretion, and wait until the end of this video, you're going to hear a story that's going to blow your mind. You won't believe it, but you wait, because it's a good one, that. Okay, true story. You need to listen to it. So the idea is that in families, a lot of people don't actually know within their family what their siblings do, you know, what they actually do or what their parents actually do. So it was quite funny because Clark and I were talking. He just arrived last night from Munich and he's here for the Christmas period, and his partner's coming over just after Christmas. So it's my turn, really, just to introduce and find out, Clark. Obviously, look, I remember when you left school, you did Morrison's for a bit of a stopgap. You became a mortgage broker here, and you trained down in Wales, and you went into London. Quite a hard job.
It was, yeah. It was quite demanding. Lots of pressure, for sure. But there was some sort of enjoyment to it as well. It was rewarding, so.
Yeah,
I enjoyed it. I learned a lot of things, definitely a lot of things.
Yeah, and even when you were training to do your CMAP, which is one of the qualifications you need to do, we used to have good discussions about, you know, how properties work and what you do, because you needed to understand a bit about investment in property, didn't you, obviously?
I did, and obviously that's why I was lucky enough to have you as my dad. Investing in property and teaching and so on. But yeah, I had a level of understanding going in there because it wasn't just residential mortgages I would do. I had the chance to do the buy-to-let commercial side of things as well, which was very, very interesting. It can get complicated as well, but it was very interesting for me.
Excellent. Yeah. So then you met a lovely young lady.
I did, in London, when I used to dance, yeah.
Yeah, he's a fantastic dancer, he really is. Yeah,
she's from Germany, from Munich.
Whereabouts does your family live?
Family live close to the border of Czech Republic.
What's it called?
It's called Calm.
Calm.
Okay. Beautiful, beautiful small city.
Yeah, we went there for Christmas, didn't we?
Yeah, it was very nice.
And the reason he's here for this Christmas is because he doesn't really want to eat sausage this Christmas, do you? He wants a proper English.
I'm tired of the sausage. I need some English food.
So Clark, what do you do now? Because you applied for jobs to go and live in Munich.
That's right. So I wouldn't move until I found a job. I wanted that security. So I went over finally, getting the good news, and I just worked for a service provider for other companies, just basically bringing in leads and then passing them on. That I used as thankfully a stepping stone, because with the German not being 100%, I needed to find something that was fitting for English speaking as well. And then I thankfully came into this amazing company called Altium. We actually develop and provide software for chips when people design chips.
Not fish and chips.
No, not fish and chips. So the PCBs, the printed circuit board, that's in every single piece of technology. But the crazy thing is that it can be used in every industry. So we have customers all over the world, and you can use it in medicine, in the automotive industry, in the aviation industry, everywhere. It's really, really impressive. Very, very impressive.
And not just that, but I can tell you that, look, with Clark, and this is good for you in property journey. I remember even when he was working in Morrison's, sometimes, you know, he got in a couple of times late. And I, right back then, soon after leaving school, I said to him, son, forget about getting there on time. Get there 20 minutes early. And you still do that today, don't you?
Yeah, 100%.
You go get there half an hour, 20 minutes earlier than you're needed.
Yeah.
And when the time comes to leave, you don't look at the clock. You carry on until you actually finish.
Definitely,
And that has got him recognised, and you got an award not so long ago, a few months back, didn't you?
I did, yeah.
What was that for?
For for basically hard work and just...
Isn't it the best one?
It was like the top three type of, okay. yeah, top three performers basically. And that was just due to getting in there early and staying until I had everything I needed to be done, yeah.
Oh, no, but you're one of the top sellers as well.
I am, yes, thankfully.
Yeah. No,
but
it works
I've got
hard.
My dad to thank for that.
So. No, but it works hard. No, listen, look, what is wealth? Honestly, with my family, you know, I have my daughter who turned 13 this week, a teenager. But, you know, my wealth in my family, I'm one of the richest men I know. I am, and I'm very, very proud of my sons, who you can see are all hugely taller than me. Because what are you, 6'2"?
6'3", yeah.
6'3"? Yeah. Oh, my goodness. And I'm a titch. So, look, Clark, over to me, I'm afraid.
Yeah, so a little bit different. I interview you, I guess.
Yeah.
So I know that you invest in property and you have certain projects and things going on, but like you said in the beginning, you know, in a family, sometimes you don't always know what you're doing. So what is it that you actually do?
That's a good question. Well, look, if you go back when I started in property, you know that the Cornwall properties were a huge mistake and a huge scam that I got walked into. Mm-hmm. And I went and learned strategy. As you already know, there's different strategies to property.
Yep.
Some of them which, as you know through your mortgage experience, so I can buy, you can buy and rent them, you can buy, you can do them up and sell them, which is called a flip. And sometimes you can actually get commercial stuff, you can convert it into flats, you can do all sorts of things. But what I learned initially, because of the mistake in Cornwall, was how to do what's called a lease option. So a lease option is where I find a property where I'd like to buy it, but either I haven't got enough money or they can't sell it to me because they might even be in negative equity. Whatever the reason, it doesn't matter the reason, but I found those properties, I managed to find them, and I became an expert in that. And so I would rent them for a long period of time, 5 to 7 years. I would make monthly income, and that helped us carry the Cornwall properties because that was a big cash flow problem.
Yeah.
You know, I was only earning at the time £2,000 a month, and the mortgages and mortgage, insurance, council tax, TV license, site fees was over £2,000 a month just on those two Cornwall properties. So you can see, you don't remember the stress.
No, I don't.
Look, Clark used to, he remembered when I was chefing. You remember those days?
Yeah.
And you used to come down sometimes as a treat and you watch me in there.
Mm-hmm.
And do you remember what I used to say to you?
No.
About, you know, because I worked hard, didn't I? That was hard work.
Yeah, of course.
It's as though, silly. How hot was it in that kitchen?
Oh, it was really, really hot, yeah.
You know, we're cooking for all the rich and famous. Did you see any famous people there when you came down?
I think it was a rugby player. I saw an England rugby player. But
Will Carling, I think.
Yeah, probably. I'm not
so, sure. So, you know, all the rich and famous there. But the interesting thing is that he used to say, oh, Dad, this is amazing. And I said, hey, do you want to be the one working in the kitchen or do you want to be the person sitting upstairs paying for a nice expensive meal? Mm-hmm. And you sit upstairs now for a nice expensive meal. Yeah. You do, don't you?
Yeah.
You and your girlfriend, you have a fantastic life in Munich.
Thankfully.
You really do.
Yeah.
So I had to do that, Clark, and that made me money. So that initially was there to carry me. And then I've been fortunate in the way that because I learned that strategy, I could do what's called an assisted sale. So I would find properties that I saw that they're in bad condition, but I didn't want to buy them. So I basically did a joint venture with the owner.
Mm-hmm.
So I did this option agreement that I would put my money, which sometimes wasn't even my money, I would use other people's money, or I'd use the builder. I'd get the builder to do it for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Well, agreed to give him a profit.
Yeah.
So it was only cost me about £2,000 to do it. And then I would make money on top, £10,000-£15,000 to start with. And then it got bigger and I've done much bigger and better things.
Mm-hmm.
Then I've done some conversions and I've done some, you know, quite major refurbs as well of houses. And then I've converted things into flats as well. Not huge. You know, the thing with the property journey, Clark, is you can't go from, oh, I just want to do 30 flats because lending won't do it.
Yeah.
They just won't, you know, without the experience. So it is a progression. And as you know, now I've gone on to now build you know, houses. So I'm building 6 houses. I've got another site agreed for 22 residential units, which is 16 flats and 6 houses. Mm-hmm. I am now looking at also at a beautiful building, which I was talking about with someone the other day, which is conversion of an old, I think it was an old council building, but it's a stunning building, convert it into 15 beautiful flats. And also I'm looking at another site to build 16 flats. And I can do all of those.
Yep.
All of those. Mm-hmm. You know, and not with my money.
Yeah, it's impressive.
So look, but you don't jump from the start to the end. You can't, because you've got to build your knowledge.
Yep. And make some mistakes along the way.
You do.
Yep.
I couldn't agree more. And I think that's a beautiful thing about about life and teaching the children is, you know, go and make the mistakes and learn. I can tell you, Carl, I was doing some training recently and I took that training and I applied it, and I applied it really, really well. And I put the results of that onto a private Facebook group. And one of the guys on there who's training, he said, oh, I haven't even done my first call yet. You know, I haven't done my first action. And I was chatting to him and it was fear. He hasn't done it because he's scared to make a mistake. Now, in property, you've got to be careful. Don't do stupid mistakes because they can be really costly. But that's why people invest in training, in mentoring. And as you know, that you can't do anything without learning from the people who are ahead of you. Mm-hmm. So you can do. So what about you in your job? Do you have to learn from the people? When you went into your company, they trained you and said, this is how it is. You had to learn the product.
Yeah, definitely. The product as well, yeah, which is probably the most difficult just because of the complexity, technicalities of it. But thankfully, I came into a company where the atmosphere and the team is very close.
Yeah.
And a really good atmosphere where I could learn from the other people that had been there already. And thankfully, they'd made mistakes so I can watch their mistakes and not make them myself. And then, you know, make sure that everything's good.